just so emotional. You know, what this song is about, it's about vengeance, you know what I mean? And the day of vengeance is on my mind. But what the Lord said to me is, listen, have the patience of the saints with that devil that you fought. I don't care what you did, I'ma tell you what I thought. Cause before your eyes blink, we gon' see you coming north. What you thinking, what you thought? All them lies that they taught, it's gonna be all they fought. When God cut that time short, we gon' see you.
This means that God is This means that God's power is about to be shown on high levels. Do everybody understand that?
Turn back. They be like, what's the message?
Be like, Israel is blessed. You damn.
That trap is me. Let's get the book of Psalms, chapter 105. Yes. So you posted, this is something that y'all looked at me as strange. You see me inviting the aggression. You see me telling them to bring it. You understand that? Right. What I understood and what I know is the minute they come, that's it. It's a setup. It is a cold setup. Everybody understand that? It's a cold, it's a trap. Mm-hmm. A trap. Do y'all understand that? I'll let you understand it. You understand it soon. You understand it. Let's go from there to the book of Psalms, chapter 105. Psalms, chapter 105. Psalms, chapter 105, verse 15.
Read. Saying, touch not mine anointed.
Who said that?
God.
I want to hear everybody. Who said that?
God.
Let me get some water up here, too. Who said it?
God.
Okay, is God a man that he should lie? Is he the son of man that he should repent? What did he say to everybody on this earth?
Touch not mine anointed.
Let's go up above that. Let's make sure this was said to everybody on this earth. Let's go up to verse 14.
When they went forth from one nation to another.
Okay, so this was said to every nation. Do everybody understand that? When they went forth from one nation to another, read on.
From one kingdom to another people.
From
one kingdom to another people.
From one kingdom to another people as they traveled. Read on.
He suffered no man to do them wrong.
What that means is he didn't tolerate the wrong that they tried to do unto them. Suffered no man to do them wrong means the wrongs that they tried to do, because they did try to do wrong. And the wrongs that they tried to do was surely avenged. Do everybody understand that? Even up to seven generations in the case of Amalek. Do everybody understand that? It was always avenged. Read on.
Yea, he reproved kings for their sakes.
What did he do?
Reproved kings for their sakes.
Yeah, the minute they rose up and they thought that they was going to do anything against the children of Israel, what did he do?
Reproved kings for their sakes, saying, touch not mine anointed, and do my prophets no harm.
Okay, so this is, if you want God to show himself, bring the aggression against the nation of Israel. If you want God to show his mighty, wonderful, magnificent power, come against one of his prophets. Then you're going to clearly see the power of God. Do everybody understand that? Now, as the prophet of the Most High God telling you this, if you don't see the power of God, then that's when you know. Now you know that that can't be a prophet of God. Because every prophet that they came against, they suffered greatly for it. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? You see how bold I'm making this statement? Let's read it again. This is my time. Now, this is my time. Okay? I've never been more excited. Y'all seen that clip I put on the website, right? Let me just give you some evidence of that, okay? They came and they raided the church. They raided my house. They raided an apostle's house. They raided almost every piece of property that we have. They came and put guns in our face and guns in our children's faces. They came with pride and arrogance and anger and hatred. And since then, it's been almost 2 years, right? Unprecedented things. It's been happening in that organization that never happened in the history of the organization. Since then. A whole lot. And this is where you at, Israel. You gotta look at what God is doing, and you gotta make sure you praise him for his wonderful and his mighty acts. had an opportunity to talk to him again. And after all that happened, you may not recognize it, but they do. They do. It's a whole different, you heard what I said? They came with hatred, they came with anger, they came with guns pointed, they came damn busting down the door. Yeah, I had the opportunity to talk to them again. You know how they came? They came like this. Because damn, listen, I told y'all this story before. Remember I told you one of them asked me, what are you telling me for? Why are you wasting your time talking to me? Remember that story? And I said, because when you see, because I'm the prophet of the Almighty God. And when you see what I'm telling you happens to you, that's when you're going to know that this wasn't a waste of my time. So now they're coming like that. All right, so let's go from there. Let's go to Psalms 105. Satan, just put a dent. I got to keep going. I'm real like that. I'm unscripted, okay? I'm off the cuff, okay? Everybody understand that? And when there's anything that interferes, okay, you're trying to get me off topic, okay? All right, so where was I at? Oh, yeah, yeah. Remember Elijah the prophet? Oh, man of God. Remember that? Remember that? The fire came down and consumed gas. After a while, they realized this really is a man of God. But please. I bet you wicked niggas ain't know that, right? And please, for the young children, I'm not talking to a true brother or sister, okay? Okay? Next day, you know, you're going to have a young children. Nigga! The comforter said it. Don't talk to your brothers and sisters like that. As God is my witness, I'm sitting there amazed, and I got to prophesy again. But anyway, we gonna get to all that. Psalms 105, verse 17. Read. What verse was we in?
Verse 15.
Read verse 15. Read.
Saying, touch not mine anointed.
This is what the Lord put out, and he put it out for generations. He only have to say it once. Okay, once it's said, it's said. And it better be followed, because if it's not followed, there will be consequences. There will be repercussions and consequences. So now it's time for the righteous to be bold as a lion. Do y'all understand that? Because you are seeing and you will continue to see on a massive scale the great power of God. Do everybody understand that? Read on.
Touch not mine anointed.
Come on.
And do my prophets no harm.
Read on.
Moreover, he called for a famine upon the land.
Read on.
He brake the whole staff of bread.
Read on.
He sent a man before them.
He sent a man before them. A man sent from God. This is going into the very beginning. Read on.
Even Joseph, who was sold for a servant.
Read on.
Whose feet they hurt with fetters.
Whose feet they hurt with fetters. They had the fetters on his feet and the chains. Read on.
He was laid in iron.
He was laid in iron. They had the iron collar around his neck and around his arms and his wrists. Read on.
Until the time.
Until what?
The time.
Read on.
That his word came.
That the word of God came. Read on.
The word of the Lord.
Word of the Lord did what?
Tried him.
The word of the Lord did what?
Tried him.
Remember, Joseph was lied on and framed. And thrown in prison. Again, just because the wicked say it, that don't make it true. Do everybody understand that? Let's go to the book of Genesis chapter 39. Genesis chapter 39. Genesis chapter 39, verse 17. Read that, please.
And she spake unto him according to these words.
Read on.
Saying, the Hebrew servant which thou hast brought unto us came in unto me to mock me.
Okay, so you got to go up above this to read the story. I don't really have that much time tonight. But you're going to see that this was an evil person in power, in rulership. And she framed Joseph and she lied on him for him to be thrown into prison. Read on.
And it came to pass as I lifted up my voice and cried, that he left his garment with me and fled out.
She said that he tried to rape her and do all kinds of things to her and mock her and then ran as she screamed, which was so far from the truth. It was a flat out satanic lie. Do everybody understand that? Read on.
And it came to pass when his master heard the words of his wife.
Read on.
Which she spake unto him, saying, after this manner did thy servant to me, that his wrath was kindled.
Read on.
And Joseph's master took him.
Read on.
And put him into the prison.
Everybody see that? Everybody got that? Okay, is that something strange? Huh? This is all throughout our history. Read on.
A place where the king's prisoners were bound.
Read on.
And he was there in the prison.
Read on.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Read it again.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Read it one more time.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Say it loud.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
I want to hear everybody say it again.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Say it again.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Say it again.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Say it one more time.
But the Lord was with Joseph.
Read on.
And showed him mercy.
Right there in the prison. In the prison. While they sit there and thought they was doing him harm, and they had the fetters on his feet, and it was eventually hurting his, hurting his feet, and they had the collar iron on his neck, the Lord was with him and had mercy on him. Read on.
And gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison.
Read on.
And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in the prison.
Read on.
And whatsoever they did there, he was the doer of it.
Read on.
The keeper of the prison looked not to anything that was under his hand.
Read on.
Because the Lord was with him.
Read it again.
Because the Lord was with him.
Read it one more time.
Because the Lord was with him.
The Lord was with him. The same way the Lord is with me. The same way the Lord is with the Israelite Church of God in Jesus Christ. The covenants that the God Almighty made with me and the promises that the Lord told me, I would love to see who can do anything to me. I would love to see it. Look how bold. Look, y'all hear me? This will be up, okay, for the world here, okay? I would love to see it. I know what the Lord told me all the way, even all the way coming up here today. Coming up here today. That's how recent. You understand that? Got that? Touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Okay, I'm not up here lying like Martin Luther King. I ain't going to sit up here and say, I'm not worried about any man or anything anymore because my eyes are bah! I never was worried, okay, about any man. The only thing that ever worries me is falling out of favor with God. That's it. That's it. Well, if it's some time go by and I don't hear from him and it's a long period of time, especially if something is happening, I get nervous, okay? The only one I fear is my God. That's the only one I fear. Is he still with me? Did I do something to make him? Did I pray? I pray. He ain't come. Oh, I get nervous. I get so nervous. And then he comes. But there's not a man on earth, a man, a woman, a person, an earth that can make me nervous. I know too much and I have seen too much. Do everybody get me at all? I'm trying to make you understand me right now. I'm not crazy. Do y'all understand me? I was taken off of this earth, okay? All right? Surrounded around angels. My own eyes seen them come out the wall. Do you understand me? There's nobody on earth right now, nobody that can say that. Nobody heard the voice of the Almighty God as a child and from thenceforth. There's nobody on earth that can say that. You think I'm going to be afraid of a man that's so easy for God to get rid of? You think I'm going to be afraid? You think I'm going to be afraid of a kingdom that's so easy for God to get rid of? No matter how powerful and how mighty and how strong they appear to be. There's something that's known in the ghetto. It says, you done mess with the wrong run now. That's known. That's only said in the hood. Oh, you done. They usually say, you done F with the wrong one. Oh, you done. You in trouble. Read on.
Genesis chapter 39, the end of verse 23.
Okay, now that's it. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 4. Be assured of this. Everything I do, everything, I was told by God to do it. Everything that I set up, the way this nation is running, everything is not my wisdom and my instructions. It's me following the instructions that was given by the Almighty God. Do everybody understand that?
All right.
Everybody got that? Without a shadow of a doubt. Okay, without a shadow of a doubt. There's nothing, okay, that I do that God didn't tell me to do. Do everybody understand that? Let's get 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. That's why I'm here and I'm still here. That's why I'm here and I'm going to always be here. Until I leave here, I'm going to always be here until I leave here and then be in Jerusalem, okay? Which we're going to talk about that a little bit in depth tonight. We're going to talk about that tonight. Because the last exodus out of Egypt, the first Passover, okay, what was going on? Okay, the children of Israel was in bondage in the first Passover, right? They were in chains and shackles, right? It was hard bondage, correct? The Lord came and said, let my people go, correct? Right? Sent Moses, right? Devastated the land of Egypt with mighty plagues, correct? And it was to free a nation, right? What's going to be the cause of the second Exodus now? Israel ain't in that hard bondage. These sort of learned that lesson. They said, listen, unless you want what happens to them Egyptians, we better find a way to let these niggas out these chains, okay? These Edomites, they learn from the past. They learn their lessons. And they think they smarter than God, okay? So that's why they out the chains. So what's going to be the reason now? That's going to bring on the wrath of God to cause Jeremiah chapter 16 to come to pass. Because if you don't know anything, you should know this. Every word of God is going to come to pass. We'll talk about that a little bit later on, all right? Let's go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4.
Read it. For I know nothing by myself.
Yeah, this is me giving that testimony in the same testimony that was given by all of the prophets. This is not our wisdom. This is not our plan. This is not our guidance. We are inspired by the Spirit of the Almighty God, heavily endowed and heavily filled with it. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? Read it again.
For I know nothing by myself.
Read on.
Yet am I not hereby justified.
Read on.
But he that justifieth me is the Lord.
But he that justifieth me, the one that's going to justify the prophets is God, because God is the only one that knows that the prophet is doing everything that God told them to do. Let's get the book of St. John chapter 12, verse 49. St. John chapter 12, verse 49. Let's get that. Read verse 49. Read that.
For I have not spoken of myself.
What did Jesus Christ say?
For I have not spoken of myself.
Read on.
But the Father, which sent me, he gave me a commandment.
He did what?
Gave me a commandment.
Read on.
What I should say.
What I shall say. Read on.
And what I should speak.
Read it again from the top.
For I have not spoken of myself.
Read on.
But the Father, which sent me.
But the Father, which sent me, Jesus Christ said. Read on.
He gave me a commandment.
Okay, this is how things work. Again, where do you find God? You find God in order. Do everybody understand that?
All right.
Christ didn't come down here without orders. Okay, and this is God. Okay, this is the creator of all, but he's still subject to his Father. And it says, he said his Father told him everything to say, what I shall say. Read on.
And what I should speak.
And what I should speak. Everything that he should say and everything that he should do was directly from the Father. Do everybody understand that?
All right.
Luke chapter 21, verse 12. Read that, please.
But before all these, they shall lay their hands on you.
Okay, this is the prophecies of the Almighty. Read, turn it on. Read on.
And persecute you.
And do what?
Persecute you.
When November the 1st first happened and I put that video up, what did I say? The persecution has begun. Right? I was letting y'all know that's not the end, but that's just the beginning. Do everybody understand that?
Right.
Always honest with you. Everybody got that?
Right.
They shall lay hands on you. What verse you in?
Verse 12.
Okay, they shall lay hands on you and persecute you. Read on.
Delivering you up to the synagogue.
Read on.
And into prisons.
And into prisons. Read on.
Being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake.
Okay, so now, okay, the purpose of this, the true purpose of this is for the testimony to go out against them. Do everybody understand that?
Right.
A true prophet have to go through those things because the prophet, when he gets in front of them, what he's going to do is he's going to testify. Right. the same way that's what Christ did. This is why you got to learn your Bible. Okay? Pilate was asking them all kind of questions, and what he did, he was testifying to the truth. Do everybody understand that? Right. Everybody got that? Right. So, again, read on.
Verse 13.
Come on.
And it shall turn to you for a testimony.
And it shall turn to you for a testimony. That's the true purpose of why the prophets is there. To say, you understand what's about to happen to your kingdom? Why they sitting up there? Read on.
Settle it therefore in your hearts, not to meditate before what you shall answer.
Yeah, because this is not of man, this is of God. Read on.
For I will give you a mouth and wisdom.
Read on.
Which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist.
As God is true to his word, that's exactly what he does. Read on.
And ye shall be betrayed, both by parents.
So the Lord told you that this would be happening during a time where there would be great evil among the nation of Israel. And then you will have people that's close to you that would be traitors. They would be parents. They would be older. They would be younger. They would be coming from all areas of life. You'll be shocked. And you're going to be shocked when you actually see all of the evil. That's why the righteous got to be, you got to be prepared to stand against the evil, not be shocked by it, not be afraid of it, but to stand against it. Do everybody understand that? And you shall be betrayed. Read on.
Both by parents.
Read on.
And brethren.
Read on.
And kinsfolk.
And kinsfolks. Read on.
And friends.
And friends. Read on.
And some of you shall they cause to be put to death.
Okay, so this is twofold. That's what happened to the early Israelite church of God and Jesus Christ. Okay? Not going to happen now. Not going to happen now. Do you understand that? Some of you, they're not cause going to be put to death. They're going to lie like hell and manufacture and make up stuff, and that's all the power they got. There's this system and this society will not be able to touch the hair of your head as far as harming you. This is why I went back again to show you where it says, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Do everybody understand that? They were martyred. The first and early church were martyred. They went through that. Now we at the end. That is not going to repeat itself. Do everybody understand that? Now it's time for the judgment to come back on this society and this kingdom. Read on.
Verse 17.
Come on.
And you shall be hated of all men for my name's sake.
Okay, so when you see that, that's not supposed to shake you either. You're supposed to be smiling at that. Do everybody understand that? Okay, read on.
But there shall not an hair of your head perish.
Okay, so it's letting you know that was twofold. It was going to happen twice. The first early church, some of them, they put to death. They caused to be put to death. The last ones to fulfill this prophecy, not a hair of your head shall perish. Praise God Almighty. Praise the Lord our God, Jesus Christ, Israel. You shall be pleased, but not a hair of your head shall perish. Read on.
In your patience.
Read on.
Possess ye your souls.
You're about to be patiently waiting on God. Do everybody understand that? You're supposed to be humming and tapping your fingers like you know something. Do everybody understand that? If you lose patience, then you can lose your soul because now you done stepped outside of the order of God. But in your patience, all you're supposed to be waiting on is the deliverance. You're supposed to be like, you know what's about to happen. Do everybody understand that? I wish y'all guys could just see some tapes of how the Lord have me in action in front of these demons. Okay, y'all be so inspired because they get inspired. They be pleading for their lives. Right. But what about us? What about the good ones? Wow. I said, unfortunately. I'm telling you, this was a question. This was a question the other day. I said, unfortunately, let's just take it this way. What if Iran came and conquered America? I said, even though they conquered the country, what you think is going to happen to the individual citizens? They was like, Yeah, I get it. It was like, I get it. I said, yeah, well, God coming to conquer the country, and it's you as individuals is not looking good for you. And they was believing every word that came out of my mouth because they knew they was talking to a prophet. Did everybody understand that? I said, the problem is, in every society, there has to be law and order. Okay, don't boast about your goodness, okay? This is everywhere. Nobody's going to just want somebody to bust through their door and steal their stuff. Right. In every society, there's enforcement set up to make sure that people do good. Right. I said, so you ain't supposed to get patted on the back for that? I said, but what you're not supposed to do is evil. Mm. Now, how you expect not to get judged for that? Mm. But anyway, we ain't going to go into all those conversations. I mean, you know, I was mad that time was expiring. I was like, damn, I ain't got no more time, man. In your patience, possess ye your souls. That means you can't lose patience, no matter how bad it may look. Remember, this guy's most powerful man on the planet. Do everybody understand that? They like to come and they like to throw tear gas in your face and have you damn rubbing your eyes and screaming, okay? All right, that's what they like to do, okay? Everybody got that? Did y'all forget that demands is going to have to be made? Did y'all forget about that? Okay, so when you out there making demands, what if Pharaoh's heart is hardened like hell, okay? They start throwing all kinds of smoke bombs in your throat. Huh? That's why the scripture says, you need courage for this time. And the only way you're going to have courage is if you really believe in God, because you know God got you. That's why he got in the book of Revelations for all the suckers, for all the punks, for all the traitors, for all the people that looked at what they saw, and not what they believe. The fearful and the unbelieving, they shall have their part in a lake that burns. Do everybody understand that? All of the fearful. Do everybody get it? Okay, everybody got that, right? So you can't be afraid. How you gonna be afraid when God told you not to be afraid? Read it again.
In your patience, possess ye your souls.
In your patience, possess ye your souls. So as long as you remain patient, patiently waiting on God to bring forth his mighty, magnificent work, then you're going to possess your soul.
No matter what you see, no matter what the details is of God.
In verse 11, read that for me, please.
For the children being not yet born, neither having done any good or evil.
Come on.
That the purpose of God, according to election, might stand.
What this is going into, that is going to boil down to Esau and Jacob. That's what it's going into. God got a purpose. And his purpose is going to stand. And it's going to be between Esau and Jacob that's going to bring about the mighty power of God. And Ezra was shown a vision similar to this and said Esau is the end of the world. And Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. This is what everything boils down to. Read on.
Not of works, but of him that calleth.
Meaning we ain't had to do nothing to be in this position. God called and have chosen us to play this part. Read on.
He was said unto her, the elder shall serve the younger.
Esau will serve us. Read on.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
God do love us. Read on.
But Esau have I hated.
And Esau is hated. Read on.
What shall you say? What shall we say then?
Come on.
Is there unrighteousness with God?
Yeah, because he's not treating everybody the same. What Bible are people reading? Read on.
God forbid.
Come on.
For he saith to Moses,
come on,
I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy.
You can't question God and question his righteousness and question his motives and question his decision. He could do what he want. He's God. Read on.
And I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion.
Okay, you can't look at him and say his ways is not equal or not right. He's going to do what he want to do. Read on.
So then, it is not of him that willeth.
Read on.
Nor of him that runneth.
Yeah, it's not of man's will or man trying to run into this position. Read on.
But of God.
But of who?
God.
Read on.
That showeth mercy.
And this is what everybody forgetting. They keep thinking man is in charge. Man think he's, Esau think he's in charge. Right. It's God that shows mercy. Read on.
For the scriptures saith unto Pharaoh.
Okay, now here we go. Here we go. This is coming back to Esau now. Read on.
Even for this same purpose have I raised thee up.
For this same purpose have I made you so powerful. Why did God make this man so powerful? Huh? For him to sit there and boast and say, my button is bigger than yours, okay? Fire and fury. And you see little Kim, that cat coming to the damn negotiating table. Man. After all that talking, man, that cat coming to the negotiating table, okay? Nah, we not negotiating. We ain't coming to the negotiating table, okay? Okay, talk about fire and fear. We're going to tell you that our button is bigger than yours.
Right.
I mean, listen. We made for this. We're going to be talking about this a little later on. There's nothing in this society to be afraid of. Read on.
Middle of verse 17.
Come on.
That I might show my power in thee.
That I might show my power. I made you so powerful, but now it's going to be against Esau and Jacob. I'm going to make Esau so powerful that it's going to be like nobody can take you down, and then I'm going to have little Jacob come and be destroyed over that. See that? See that? Same. Didn't that happen in Egypt? Is that hard for you to believe now? Read on.
And that my name might be declared throughout all the earth.
Read on.
Therefore, have you mercy on whom he will have mercy.
Read on.
And whom he will, he hardeneth.
Okay, and whom he will, he make them hard-headed. Okay, he want them to keep coming. Do everybody understand that? He's the one that hardens their heart so he could jack them up. Read on.
Thou wilt say then unto me.
Okay, let's go back to Jeremiah 50 now. Jeremiah 50. Okay. So remember I told y'all there was going to be either before Passover or after Passover. Remember I told you that? Okay, why would I say something like that? Because I know it was coming soon based on the last thing that God told me. So now for me to say either before or after, that means I had to wait on him and come and tell me something else to actually know when to start. Everybody understand that? Okay, so now we're going to hear about it, okay? He came and told me to something else. Let's read Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 22. Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 22. Read that.
A sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction.
Okay, all this is coming to Babylon. All this is coming to America. Everybody understand that?
Cut.
Everybody got that?
Cut.
Coming to America. Everybody got that? A sound of battle in the land and of great destruction. Everybody understand that?
Cut.
Now, don't get it confused, okay? This is not us battling Babylon. Okay, the Lord is going to take this place down. But Babylon is going to be under heavy attacks. Some of these attacks is being planned by Esau. Some of these attacks is going to be coming from terrorists. This place is just not going to be a comfortable place to live. Do everybody understand that?
Right.
Everybody got that?
Right.
The Lord going to let it be unleashed. Let it be unleashed on this place. Do everybody understand that? And only the ones that abide under the shadow of the Most High is going to be under the protection where you ain't going to die here in Babylon. Everybody understand that? A sound of battle in the land. Read on. And of great destruction. Read on.
How is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken?
Okay, then now we know from prophecy that the rulers of darkness is going to hate Babylon, and that their plan is to burn her flesh with fire. So they're going to let this place get destroyed. Okay, almost to the ground. Everybody understand that?
Right.
Just to bring about their new system, which is already in effect. Do everybody understand that?
Right.
Read on.
How has Babylon become a desolation among the nations?
Read on.
I have laid a snare for thee.
But the Lord put a trap right in the midst of Babylon. He put a trap. God said, I have laid a snare for thee. A trap! Read on.
And thou art also taken.
And they're going to be taken by them. Just like that. You see how it says also taken? Just like they got all the sounds of battle in the land and they're going through hell and this and that. And happened. The Lord said, I got a trap for you waiting as well. And you also going to be taken by this trap. Read on.
O Babylon.
Come on.
And thou was not aware.
You ain't got no idea that I was coming at you like this.
Read on. Thou art found.
Thou art found. Read on.
And also caught.
And what?
Also caught.
And caught. Read on.
Because thou hast striven against the Lord.
Yeah, because you have striven against the Lord. Now the Lord has prepared this trap for you. Everybody got that? What y'all think that trap is? What y'all think that trap is? Open for Harley guessing the right on earth. Come on, only me all day. God wants to spend about 2 minutes on this. What y'all think that trap is?
He came against the prophet of God.
Come on, what y'all think that trap is? What you think that trap is? Huh? What y'all think that trap is?
He came
Israelites. What y'all think that trap is?
It came against God's people.
Now, how would that be the trap? Huh? What y'all think that trap is? What y'all think that trap is? What y'all think that trap is? Now y'all gonna be y'all waiting for the answer, right? Y'all gonna be shocked when I give you the answer, right? They partially had it over there. That trap is me. It's like I'm a model, right? I'm like, that trap is me. Not the prophets, because I don't know another one right now. Unless you know another one you can tell me about, okay? You're sharp and pleased. This is why I'm the target. Why y'all don't understand that? This is why all the hate is directed at me. This is why, again, they believe that the leaders of the darkness of this world, okay, even though they know. So they're trying to do things in a very careful way because they know who I am. But they believe if we could just destroy him, if we could get rid of him, then we could get everything back to the way it was before him. There's only few people that know how it was before me. Right, Holy Apostle Shaw? Right, Holy Apostle Ariel? Yeah, there's only few people that know how it was before. We need to get everything back to that. Okay, because ever since he came, we ain't got an inch in. We ain't able to do our will. Right. Let's get rid of him. Let's cause them to stop believing that he is sent by God. And let's move him out of the way. And that's exactly what God wants them to do. He wants them to believe that. Because the minute that they touch his anointed and try to do his prophets harm, this is what's going to bring about the second exodus out of Egypt. You probably ain't going to understand it, but you will. You probably don't understand it right now, but you will. You will. You will. Do everybody understand that? Again, a lot of y'all don't understand what it is that God has done when he sent me into the nation of Israel. And he started working through me to do the things that was done in the nation of Israel. There was a 360 degrees turnaround. Do everybody understand that? Okay, we were down to the ground. Do y'all understand that? Not a nickel, not a dime. Right? Not a nickel, not a dime, okay? And it was turned around. I'm not a congregation, right? Not even a congregation. Am I correct? Okay, then people started coming out the woodworks looking for me. Where that young man at with all the wisdom? Right? You don't forgot? Huh? Because the Lord was setting up a new order. I ain't building off of nobody else's foundation. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? Okay, so now, what did the Lord say? This is God saying this. Read that one more time.
Verse 24.
Read.
I have laid a snare for thee.
I have laid a snare for thee. Read on.
And thou art also taken.
Come on.
O Babylon, and thou wast not aware. Thou art found, and also caught. Because thou hast striven against the Lord.
Now look at this. Look at this. The Lord's talking about laying a trap. But before he got to the point of talking about laying a trap, what did he say before that? Let's go back. Let's go up to verse 4. Read verse 4 and look at this. Verse 4.
In those days and in that time, saith the Lord.
Read on.
The children of Israel shall come, they and the children of Judah together.
Read on.
Going and weeping.
Read on.
They shall go.
Read on.
And seek the Lord their God.
Read on.
They shall ask the way to Zion.
Where are they going?
To Zion.
Where are they going?
To Zion.
Where are they going?
To Zion.
Read on.
With their faces thitherward.
Read on.
Saying, come and let us join ourselves to the Lord.
Read on.
In a perpetual covenant that shall not be forgotten.
Read on.
My people have been lost sheep. Their shepherds have caused them to go astray.
Read on.
They have turned them away on the mountains. They have gone from mountain to hill.
Read on.
They have forgotten their resting place.
They've forgotten that they were Israelites from Israel. Read on.
All that found them have devoured them.
This is the history of the nation of Israel. Read on.
And their adversary said, we offend not.
Yeah, who are these people? These people are worth nothing. Read on.
Because they have sinned against the Lord.
Read on.
The habitation of justice.
Read on.
Even the Lord, the hope of their fathers.
Read on.
Remove out of the midst of Babylon.
Read on.
And go forth.
Into what?
Go forth.
Read on.
Out of the land of the Chaldeans.
Read on.
And be as the he-goats before the flocks.
And be as the he-goats before the flocks. Let's jump to verse 20. Read verse 20.
Read. In those days and in that time, saith the Lord, the iniquity of Israel shall be sought for.
Remember when we went through this understanding? Read on.
And there shall be none.
Read on.
And the sins of Judah.
Read on.
And they shall not be found.
Read on.
For I will pardon them whom I reserve.
Okay, remember we went through that when we get back to Jerusalem? Let's jump to verse 22. So now, what did that do now? Verse 22, read.
A sound of battle is in the land.
Now we back to where it is. Read on.
And of great destruction.
Read on.
How was the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? How has Babylon become a desolation among the nations? I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken.
And thou art also taken. Read on.
O Babylon, and thou wast not aware. Thou art found and also caught, because thou hast striven against the Lord.
Because thou hast what?
Striven against the Lord.
Let's jump to verse 28 now.
The voice of them that flee and escape out of the land of Babylon.
Read on.
To declare in Zion.
To declare it in Zion, in Jerusalem. Read on.
The vengeance of the Lord.
It was God's vengeance. Read on.
Our God.
Read on.
The vengeance of his temple.
In the vengeance of his temple. Do everybody understand that? That's what caused this. That's what brought this whole thing on. Do everybody understand that? Right there in scripture. Everybody see that, right? Let's jump to verse 30. Verse 30. Read.
Therefore shall her young men fall in the streets.
So this is what's going to be happening in Babylon. Read on.
And all her men of war shall be cut off in that day.
And all her men of war shall be cut off. So they're going to be, there's going to be all kind of terrorism and all kind of attacks and all kind of things going on where a lot of the law enforcement is going to be being put to death. Read on.
Saith the Lord.
Come on.
Behold, I am against thee, O thou most proud.
Come on.
Saith the Lord God of hosts.
Come on.
For thy day is come. The time that I will visit thee.
Read on.
And the most proud shall stumble and fall.
Read on.
And none shall raise him up.
Read on.
And I will kindle a fire in his cities.
Come on.
And it shall devour all round about him.
Read on.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts.
Read on.
The children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together.
Read on.
And all that took them captives held them fast.
That means held them tight. Read on.
They refused to let them go.
Read on.
Their Redeemer is strong.
But the one that's going to cause them to be let go is strong. Read on.
The Lord of hosts is his name.
The Almighty Yahweh. Read on.
He shall thoroughly plead their cause.
Read on.
That he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon.
Read on.
A sword is upon the Chaldeans, saith the Lord.
Read on.
And upon the inhabitants of Babylon and upon her princes and upon her wise men.
Okay, so this is what you see going on. The shaking of the land of the hand of the Lord of hosts is if it's even reached up into the higher echelons of their society. Isn't that correct? Damn, now you, how do you know something is happening? When they start telling on themselves. Now you know for sure that this is what's going down because they at war with one another. Everybody understand that? So now you hear it coming from Congress. Now you hear it coming from the President of the United States, how corrupt the FBI is, how corrupt the Justice Department is, how they set cases up, how they frame people, how they set you up. And now you're starting to hear all this, right?
Moving on now, bombshell report in the New York Times about the FBI and President Trump. The Times reporting the FBI launched a secret counterintelligence investigation into the president after he fired FBI Director James Comey. The goal? To determine whether the president of the United States was a national security threat working for the Russians. Tonight, President Trump is responding, blasting Comey and the FBI, and tying the report to what he calls the Russia investigation witch hunt. Here's ABC White House correspondent Tara Palmieri.
Tonight, a bombshell report in the New York Times claiming the FBI opened a secret investigation into whether the president was working on behalf of Russia when he fired FBI Director James Comey. Comey had been investigating whether Trump's campaign had colluded with Russia in the 2016 election. According to the paper, the FBI became suspicious after these comments directly following the firing.
When I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story. It's an excuse by the Democrats for having lost an election that they should have won.
Another red flag, a leaked Oval Office conversation between Trump and two high-level Russian officials the day after Comey's dismissal. He reportedly called him a nut job and said firing the FBI director took pressure off the administration. The president this morning firing back in a tweet saying, quote, wow, just learned in the failing New York Times that the corrupt former leaders of the FBI opened an investigation on me for no reason and with no proof after I fired lying James Comey.
If you haven't heard it, don't worry. I'll put it on my website. Now that they're doing it to each other, they're telling on each other. But they, when they was doing it to us, they were always doing it to us, and they just told us that's the system. Everybody understand that? Read on.
Verse 36.
Come on.
A sword is upon the liars.
A sword is upon the liars. They're all liars. Everybody understand that? Sure. You can't believe a damn thing that come out of their mouth. They're all liars, okay? Read on.
And they shall dote. A sword is upon her mighty men.
And a sword is upon her mighty men. Read on.
And they shall be dismayed.
Dote is to be like silly, okay? They're gonna be silly and dismayed when they see how the Lord bring these judgments in them, confound them with the judgments that he's bringing. Read on.
A sword is upon their horses and upon their chariots.
Come on.
And upon all the mingled people that are in the midst of her.
So this is actually showing you that this is not just talking about ancient Babylon. In the Babylonians, this is not just referring to one man that the Lord named by name. That was Cyrus. That was actually going to come and destroy them. So it's letting you know this is history repeating itself. It was one man that the Lord said that was going to cause them to be destroyed. In ancient Babylon, that was Cyrus. Everybody understand that?
Sure.
But now this is alluding to Esau's Babylon. Now starting to allude to Esau's Babylon when it starts talking about all the mingled people that are in the midst of her. Everybody understand that?
Sure.
You're going to see that this is Esau Babylon without a shadow of a doubt. Read on.
The end of verse 37.
Come on.
And they shall become as women.
Read on.
A sword is upon her treasures.
Come on.
And they shall be robbed.
And they shall be robbed. Let's get the book of Isaiah chapter 33. The book of Isaiah chapter 33. Isaiah chapter 33, verse 1. All of that wasn't for no reason. The pending doom, the blood moon, the super blood moon. I mean, there's so many prophecies, there's so many warnings. Everybody understand that?
Sure.
You throw all those warnings. Again, the Lord ain't going to threaten. Okay, the scripture says, he shall threaten and who shall not be utterly destroyed. Okay? The Lord ain't going to threaten and there ain't going to be no results behind it. Do everybody understand that? Sure. Let's go to the book of Isaiah chapter 31, verse 33, verse 1. Read.
Woe to thee that spoilest.
Read on.
And thou wast not spoiled.
Yeah, woe to thee that just robbed everybody and you wasn't robbed. Okay, that's the white man. Read on.
And dealest treacherously.
That dealt treacherously with everybody. Read on.
And they dealt not treacherously with thee.
And you had people that had good faith when they first was trying to deal with you, like the so-called American Indians or North American Indians. Read on.
When thou shalt cease to spoil.
Okay, so when now you done and you done robbed the whole earth and now you trying to live peaceably, when you think that you done got everything under your control, read on.
Thou shalt be spoiled.
Then it's going to be time for you to give up the spoils. Everybody understand that? Read on.
And when thou shalt make an end to deal treacherously.
And when you saying ain't nobody else to deal treacherously with, we done damn conquered and destroyed everybody. Read on.
They shall deal treacherously with thee.
Okay, you're going to be the one that's going to be dealt treacherously with. Let's get the book of Revelation chapter 13, verse 10. Right to the point. Revelation chapter 13, verse 10. Read that, please. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the faith. Here is the patience in the faith of the saints. Do everybody see that? That's the word of God that must come to pass and must be fulfilled, which will be fulfilled in your lifetime, like I've been telling you all along. Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 50. Let's go back there. Jeremiah chapter 50. If you wanted to live long enough to see the power of God, well, keep breathing, okay? Any day now. Don't wake up dead tomorrow, okay? Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 44. Read.
Behold, he shall come up like a lion before the swelling of Jordan, unto the habitation of the strong.
Read on.
But I will make them suddenly run away.
Read on.
From her.
Read on.
And who is a chosen man?
So this prophecy speaks about a particular man that the Lord was going to use. A man in particular that was chosen by God to bring about those end results. which would be the destruction of Babylon. Y'all ain't put no new batteries in here? The batteries die. All you have to do is put new batteries in it. Okay, see, young officers, I need help. Graduate and get into the ranks, okay? All right, these brothers is, I don't know. Where's we at? You see this? I speak off the cuff, okay? I don't have a scripture. I got scriptures in front of me. That's it, okay? I ain't got prepared statements and words that was written by somebody else, okay? It's not how I do it, okay? Jeremiah chapter 50, and where was we at? Verse 44. Read that again.
Behold, he shall come up like a lion from the swelling of Jordan.
Come on.
Unto the habitation of the strong.
Come on.
But I will make them suddenly run away from her.
Read on.
And who is a chosen man?
Okay, so there was a man that the Lord has chosen to bring about those results in ancient Babylon. That was Cyrus. Okay, he named him by name. Do everybody understand that? That brought about those results. Now, who's that man in modern day Babylon? Who's that chosen man in modern day Babylon? You're looking at him. You're looking at him. Yeah. Okay. We got to move on. Thank you. We got to move on. Listen, you don't want to make the demons too mad. They got to stand up and clap because they think I'm going to tell them to get out. Yeah. Now look at this closely. Who is a chosen man? Read on.
That I may appoint over her.
Well, once we get into Jerusalem, brother, once we get into Jerusalem, this is what you don't understand. Okay, we're going to leave through the power of the Almighty God, they're going to be left so devastated that we better not have to say nothing to them. Do everybody understand that? Sure. You need to go back to Revelations, okay, where the prophecy states that we shall smite the earth with plagues as often as we will. Right. You know what kind of fear that's going to bring on them? I'm like, we have one of our citizens over there. We heard he reported back that the cops pulled him over. Is that true? Like, tell us the name of the precinct. We'll deal with him ourselves. Read on.
The end of verse 44.
Come on.
For who is like me?
For who is like me? You see that? So then you may think to yourself, well, how is this Cyrus in the past? How can Cyrus be like God? Again, the Lord put the spirit on him to fulfill his will. Cyrus was fulfilling God's will. Okay, God told him everything that he better do. He let the Israelites go back into Jerusalem. Okay, again, you got to see the similarities. Rebuild the temple. Do everybody understand that? Destroy the Babylonians. Okay? As if Christ was coming and doing it himself. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? What verse we in?
The end of verse 44.
What chapter we in?
Jeremiah chapter 50.
Okay, I'll be having to find my place. Okay, Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 44. Read it again.
Behold, he shall come up like a lion from the swelling of Jordan.
Come on.
Unto the habitation of the strong.
Read on.
But I will make them suddenly run away from her.
Read on.
And who is a chosen man?
Read on.
That I may appoint over her.
Read on.
For who is like me?
Read on.
And who will appoint me the time?
Read on.
And who is that shepherd?
And who is that what?
That shepherd.
Read on.
That will stand before me.
Now y'all see those verses y'all just read? And again, remember how the word of God transcends time because it's there waiting on another kingdom, right? I'm going to show you those same words for another kingdom. Let's go to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 49. Jeremiah, chapter 49, and we're going to start at verse 19. Jeremiah, chapter 49, verse 19.
Read. Behold, he shall come up like a lion from the swelling of Jordan.
Didn't we just read that? Read on.
Against the habitation of the strong.
Read on.
But I will suddenly make him run away from her.
Read on.
And who is a chosen man?
This is no longer talking about Cyrus now. This is somebody else that God has chosen. Read on.
That I may appoint over her.
Read on.
Or who is like me?
Read on.
And who will appoint me the time? And who is that shepherd?
And who is that what?
That shepherd.
Read on.
That will stand before me.
Read on.
Therefore, hear the counsel of the Lord.
Read.
That he have taken against Edom.
Against who?
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 Against Edom.
Against these Edomites. Against the Babylon that Esau is in charge of. And the scriptures was telling them in the past, once that chosen man, once he appears on the scene, that's the beginning of your end. Do everybody understand that? Right. Now this is the counsel. According to the prophet Jeremiah, this is the counsel of the Lord, but this time it is for Edom. Read verse 19, verse 20 again. Read it again.
Therefore, hear the counsel of the Lord.
Read on.
That he have taken against Edom.
That he have taken against Edom. Now, watch what he said to Edom. This is his counsel. This is what he's saying to Edom. Read on.
And his purposes.
And his what?
Purposes.
His purposes. What God intends to do. Read on.
That he have purpose against the inhabitants of Teman.
And this is what he have purpose. This is how he said he's going to do it. Read.
Surely.
What did he say?
Surely.
Read on.
The least of the flock.
Read on.
Shall draw them out.
Okay, surely the least of the flock is going to bring them into this destruction. Everybody see that?
Lord.
Everybody see that? See, Lord. Y'all got confused right now because you've been listening to a false breakdown for decades, okay? You've been listening to lies, okay? And the Lord, he had it that way. I didn't touch this for this particular reason. You had to wait for the time. You know who the least of the flock is? I am.
Right.
See, some of you thought it was the so-called Jew, okay? Right? Remember that? Yeah. Y'all want me to prove that I'm the least of the flock? You want me to prove it? Let's go to the book of Matthew, chapter 25. Hurry up. Matthew, chapter 25. Let's get it directly out of the Lord's mouth. Matthew, chapter 25. What's going to bring this about? What's going to bring God's mighty wrath? This is the counsel that he took up against Esau. He said, the least of the flock shall draw them out. Matthew 25, verse 40. Read it.
And the king shall answer.
Read on.
And say unto them.
Come on.
Verily I say unto you.
Come on.
Inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of
these. What?
One of the least of these my brethren.
Come on.
Ye have done it unto me.
The flock is the whole nation of Israel. If you do something to the least of any Israelites, the least, Christ said, it's like you did it unto me. Do everybody understand that? So they're going to pick what the Lord is saying in his counsel in Jeremiah chapter 49, is they're going to pick an Israelite to mess with. And that's going to draw them out. Let's go back to Jeremiah chapter 49. Y'all ain't feeling these scriptures? Am I making this stuff up? You can't deny it. We know in ancient Babylon, everybody agrees that was Cyrus. Everybody agrees. Then the Lord gave them same scriptures for another man. And he called them the least of the flock. What is that? The least of these, my little ones. One particular individual that they're going to choose to try to make an example out of. The Lord said, that's going to draw them out. Yeah. It's going to draw them out into their destruction. Into us going back to the land of Eden. That's what's going to trigger everything off. Do everybody understand that? Right. Everybody got that? Right. Okay, let's read it again. Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 49, verse 20. Read it again.
Therefore, hear the counsel of the Lord that he have taken against Edom.
Read on.
And his purposes that he have purposed against the inhabitants of Teman.
What did he say?
Surely.
What did he say?
Surely.
Did it sound like he confused? Did it sound like he going to change his mind? What did he say?
Surely.
Read on.
The least of the flock.
The least of the flock. Read on.
Shall draw them out.
This is what's going to draw them out into their destruction. Now, let's go to 1 Chronicles chapter 16. 1 Chronicles chapter 16. And it's only right that it needs to be me. Everybody understand that? Everybody got that? I wouldn't trust it to nobody else. Okay, they might run and hide. It might disappoint us. You could be sure as I am standing here in front of you, dark skin like Jesus Christ, I will not disappoint my Lord and my Savior and my King. Even if I stand alone, even though I'm supposed to stand with all the righteous. Do everybody understand that? 1 Chronicles 16, verse 8, read it.
Give thanks unto the Lord.
Give thanks unto the Lord. Read on.
Call upon his name.
Call upon his name. Read on.
Make known his deeds among the people.
This is the time, Israel. Everybody understand that? Without ceasing, you're about to see the power of God. He's real close. Do everybody understand that? For you to even want to be accepted of him and by him, you got to be right. Do everybody understand that? Always give thanks unto the Lord. call upon his name, make known his deeds among the people. Read on.
Sing unto him.
Come on.
Sing psalms unto him.
Read on.
Talk ye of all his wondrous works.
Read on.
Glory ye in his holy name.
Read on.
Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord.
Read on.
Seek the Lord in his strength.
Read on.
Seek his face continually.
This is what you do. Read on.
Remember his marvelous works.
Read on.
That he have done.
Read on.
His wonders.
Read on.
And the judgments of his mouth.
Read on.
O ye seed of Israel.
Read on.
His servants.
Read on.
Ye children of Jacob.
Read on.
His chosen ones.
Read on.
He is the Lord our God.
Yeah, there's none other. Okay, we got the only true and living God. Read on.
His judgments are in all the earth.
It is him that is passing judgments all throughout this earth. Read on.
Be ye mindful always of his covenant.
Read on.
The word which he commanded to 1,000 generations.
All the way up to the time we are living in. Read on.
Even of the covenant which he made with Abraham. And of his oath unto Isaac.
Read on.
And have confirmed the same to Jacob.
Read on.
For a law. And to Israel for an everlasting covenant.
Read on.
Saying unto thee.
What did God say unto thee?
Unto thee.
Read on.
Will I give the land of Canaan.
Read on.
The lot of your inheritance.
Read on.
When ye were but few. And even few. And strangers in it.
Read on.
And when they went from nation to nation.
Read on.
And from one kingdom to another people.
Read on.
He suffered no man to do them wrong.
Read on.
Yea, he reproved kings for their sakes.
Read on.
Saying, touch not mine anointed.
Come on.
And do my prophets no harm.
Read on.
Sing unto the Lord.
Come on.
All the earth.
Read on.
Forth from day to day his salvation.
Read on.
Declare his glory among the heathen.
Read on.
His marvelous works among all nations.
Read on.
For great is the Lord.
Come on.
And greatly to be praised.
Read.
He also is to be feared above all gods.
Read on.
For all the gods of the people are idols, but the Lord made the heavens.
Come on.
Glory and honor are in his presence. Strength and gladness are in his place.
Come on.
Give unto the Lord, ye kindreds of the people.
Read on.
Give unto the Lord glory and strength.
Read on.
Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name.
Read on.
Bring an offering.
Come on.
And come before him.
Read on.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
Read on.
Fear before him all the earth.
So he's talking to all nations. Read on.
The world also shall be stable.
Read on.
That it be not moved.
Okay, this is after they get destroyed. Read on.
Let the heavens be glad.
Come on.
And let the earth rejoice.
Read on.
And let men say among the nations.
And let men say among the nations. Read on.
The Lord reigneth.
The Lord reigneth. Come on.
And let the sea roar and the fullness thereof. Let the fields rejoice in all that is therein.
Read on.
Then shall the trees of the wood sing out at the presence of the Lord.
Come on.
Because he cometh to judge the earth.
Come on.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever.
Read on.
And say ye, save us, O God of our salvation.
Read on.
And gather us together. And deliver us from the heathen.
And do what?
Deliver us from the heathen.
Read verse 35 again. Read on.
And say ye, save us.
And say what?
Save us.
Read on.
O God of our salvation.
Read on.
And gather us together.
Okay, what is the purpose of us coming together for us to be delivered? Everybody understand that? To save us and gather us together. Read on.
And deliver us from the heathen.
And deliver us from the heathen. Read on.
That we may give thanks to thy holy name.
Read on.
And glory in thy presence.
Read on.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Read it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it with him.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it one more time.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it one more time.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it one more time.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it one more time.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it one more time.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Say it again.
Blessed be the Lord, God of Israel.
Read on.
Forever.
For what?
Forever.
Read on.
In ever.
Read on.
And all the people said, amen.
Say it.
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 Amen.
Praise the Almighty Yahweh, the Lord our God. Praise the Almighty Yahweh, the Lord our God. Jesus. Jesus Christ. That's all y'all got for God? Praise the Lord our God, Jesus Christ is real. Okay, Yeshabian, please. As I was brought up and I was being raised by the Holy Spirit of the Almighty, there was things that he instilled in me. This is just not something that happened abruptly. It just didn't happen when I went to the mountain. I was raised by this Holy Spirit and the Spirit of God Almighty. And as I grew up in the truth and watched the madness, but still knew that it was the truth. Had enough faith. The scripture says to the pure, all things is pure. That's talking about to the pure in heart. Christ said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. So to the pure, all things are pure. So as I watched the madness, I knew that it wasn't my madness. Okay. That wasn't what I meant by that. It wasn't madness for me to deal with. It was madness that God would eventually deal with. I understood that. So I never got out of order, and this could be testified about me by the men behind me that seen me in this truth as a child. But the point of me saying this is just knowing the scriptures And they have me everywhere. They just have me there, okay? I'm a little boy, and I'm sitting among elders. And I'm sitting in the councils. And I'm hearing the councils. And this is a testimony. And the testimony is the truth. This doesn't take anything away from them. But it's the truth. And I'm hearing the council, and I'm saying the council is not the council according to the way that it should be. And I sat there to myself, and I said, and it was demons among them at that time, too. And I had some heavy influences and plants planted by Esau and all, you know, working for the government. That was it. Causing havoc, okay, trying to make sure Israel never grow. Am I right? Am I right? Okay. Y'all ain't on the spot, are you? I ain't hearing too much cunts back there. I get too much support back here. I often wondered to myself, you know, because as the situations would come up, I would know the answer, and I would see the wrong answers being given. So I just say to myself, why don't they just do what God said to do? It's that easy. Why don't they just do what God said to do? There was a scripture on everything, and I couldn't get it. I said, I know these are the men of God, so why don't they just do what the Lord said? And I couldn't figure that one out. And you know, I was given the honor of an elder. Okay, they used to have counsel, and then then after they all finished talking, it was mainly a holy apostle Shaw. He used to go, Tars. And I had a voice among the council. So then I spoke, and everybody listened. Isn't that right, Shaw? And then all of a sudden, whatever I was saying is what was being implemented. Because I had that one thing that God instilled in me. Don't speak your own words. Don't do your own will. Only do what God said to do. Do everybody understand that? I get that again from, we was here earlier in St. John's chapter 12. St. John's chapter 12, verse 49. Read that. St. John's chapter 12, verse 49. Read it again. St. John chapter 12, verse 49. Come on. Yes, sir. Read.
For I have not spoken of myself.
Read on.
But the Father which sent me.
Read on.
He gave me a commandment.
Read on.
What I should say and what I should speak.
This is where that comes from. Christ, he didn't deviate from the plan. Even when it got to the point where he had to suffer. That was the commandment. This is what he said. This is what he told Peter. Shall not I drink this cup that my Father gave me to drink? He never even thought of doing it his own way. Followed the commandment all the way to the T. Do everybody understand that? Do everybody understand? This is my Lord. This is my Savior. This is my God. And this is who raised me. I know nothing else but to do exactly like he said to do, exactly like he did.
Read on. And I know that his commandment is life everlasting.
And I know that his commandment, if you follow his commandment, that's life everlasting. Read on.
Whatsoever I speak, therefore, even as the Father said unto me.
Even as the Father said unto me, no matter what it is I speak, Jesus Christ said, it was something that was said to me by the Father. Read on.
So I speak.
And because he said it, this is what I'm going to convey to everybody else. Do everybody understand that?
Right.
Everybody got that?
All right.
If you believe in your heart of hearts, for whatever reason, that God is not actually running the Israelite Church of God, Jesus Christ, you are completely out of your mind. The will of the Almighty God is implemented in the Israelite Church of God in Jesus Christ. This is why we cannot be touched. Do y'all? No, you don't. You don't understand all the entities and forces that has been coming at this nation trying to destroy it for over 20-something years now. Since I've been in my administration has been in authority. All of the things that was warded off, there's so many rules and so many things in place, and some of you have no idea that is actually protecting the congregation from the demons. Who is grueling and drooling, trying to destroy the congregation.
We gonna see.
We go.
gonna see you for that rain. We gonna see you with them plagues. We gonna see you for them days that our people was afraid. You gonna see when you amazed. We gonna see you in that grave. You gonna see when you ablaze with that fire from the lake. We gonna see you for the hate. We gonna see you as your fate. You gonna see you can't escape when we beat you out of shape. We gonna see you for them rapes in the time you called us apes. You gonna see you wore them capes, but you phony, you not great. They gonna see our God is Jake. We gonna see their God is fake. In that kingdom we gonna take. We gonna see them serve our place. We gonna see you when you fall. We gonna get you for it all. We gonna do you like a chore. We gonna get you for the poor. We gonna do you like the whore. We gonna take you on a tour. We gonna put you on the floor. We gonna get you for that search. You done ran up in our church on November on the 1st. We gonna grab you by your shirt and we gonna hit you where it hurts.
This means that God's power is about to be shown on high levels. Do everybody understand that?
We see you. We gonna see you. You know that we talk to God. He said it's almost our time. We see
no matter what you see, no matter what the details is of God's will and what happens today, understand that that's not the end.
Right.
Because I got to lead you to the
promise. Right.
Stop. So don't worry about nothing.
Right.